Alright, hello ladies and gentlemen, it's VMP and welcome back. This time we're here with another season of Perisno. It has been a while since we've played this mod, and let me tell you, they've made some great changes in the meantime. Whole bunch of new stuff. I can't wait. Let's just get started. Alright, welcome to the land of Perisno, where elves and giants roam in the ancient moors and forests, where dwarves craft great works and men form mighty empires. Dragons lurk in the dark abodes of stories old, with vast and exotic lands abound. There are many powerful kingdoms and empires waging war for control of all the land, while smaller groups and factions stake out their own claims and rivalries, sowing havoc and destruction in their wake upon the populace. You have been chosen to rise into greatness, to find your destiny. Enter, adventurer, into the world of Perisno. All right, toggle mod options permanent. Fog of War, no thank you. We do not want Fog of War. Dodge Control, I don't know what that is. They're starting with it disabled, so we're going to keep that. And Standard Troop Skill Difficulty sounds good to me. We are male. We are going to be an elf. So, the last time we tried to do a Let's Play of this was with Lux Sunbeam. And unfortunately, we were unable to do that because at that current point in time, with that version, anytime you encountered a dwarf, whether it be in combat or in a town, the game crashed. Which, since the dwarf is the dwarves are our main faction and are all around the map, was kind of a big deal. And it honestly just ruined the series for us. We had to stop it there. So, we are going to be playing as the son of Lux Sunbeam. That's my general idea right now. And kind of the story behind it, or what I'm going to do, is that Lux, for somehow, ended up getting murdered by the dwarves. That's what we're going to say. That's what happened. So this is why we're choosing personal revenge for that. And oh, hello. What is the last inheritance you choose to take with you as you start your legend? The great bow of my father and its large quiver of arrows. I don't know if Lux even made it far enough along to get a good bow. Crossbow? Nah. Lance and a warhorse? Nah. Hidden treasure and connection with the free traders. We don't really need money. Great armor and a mount that I can ride. Secret physical training of my lineage. Increase Ironflesh and athletics. That kind of sounds fun. The elephant of my father. Let's go physical training. More Ironflesh and athletics. That kind of sounds cool. Lux didn't make it far enough along. He wasn't rich yet. So it doesn't make sense for us to get any of this stuff. Let's go with this. Boom. Okay. We will be realistic as we always are. Holy shit, we're starting out with 8 iron flesh? Holy shit. Oh my god, 21 strength already? Look at this. 7 power strike, 8 iron flesh, and 6 power draw. Holy shit. He is definitely the son of Lux. Oh my god. Alright. He is going to be Lothlin Sunbeam. And so, since his father was, you know, murdered by the dwarves, I think what we're going to do with the series is our end goal is to conquer all the dwarven kingdoms. And kind of take the entire dwarven faction out. For right now, that's my goal. That's what I'm looking at. Okay, we could definitely use some proficiencies in archery. We'll try to train that up a little bit. Boom. Oh my god, if this is not the derpiest looking face I've seen in my life. Alright, give me a sec, guys. I'm going to go ahead and make something that looks at least marginally better than whatever this is. Alright, here we go. This is going to be Lothlin. You know, I was kind of hoping if we had a regular looking face, that the tiger pelt or whatever the hell he's wearing would look at least a little bit better. No, it just looks just as awful. But, you know what? We'll work with it. We'll figure something out. Okay, you hear about Perisno, a land torn between rival kingdoms battling each other for supremacy. A haven for knights and mercenaries, cutthroats and adventurers, all willing to risk their lives in pursuit of fortune, power, or glory. In this land, which holds great dangers and even greater opportunities, you believe you may leave your past behind and start a new life. You feel that finally you hold the key of your destiny in your hands, free to choose as you will, and that whatever course you take, great adventures will await you. drawn by the stories you hear about Perisno and its kingdoms, you, where do we want to go? So we could go to the Redwoods and join the elves there. However, I think I kind of want to check out the Reich again. We'll just hang out there. I think the kingdom we're going to choose for this, since it's the closest to the dwarves, is going to be the Kingdom of the Falcon, and a lot of you guys wanted to see me join that. So I think that's what we're going to choose in the long run. But for right now, it doesn't really matter. We're not going to be joining a kingdom, at least in the first couple episodes. You have come through the Drock Highlands, a plateau exposed to the bitter winds from the north. The land here is frozen for most of the year, but the forests are rich with fur-bearing game, and the rivers are teeming with fish. The riches of the land draw the traders, but the traders in turn draw bandits. You saw the occasional dark figure mounted on a shaggy pony, watching the passage of your caravan from a snowy ridge, and were glad when the spires of Murdenhall came into view across the wide valley of the Bullock River. This land's as mysterious as the stories tell of a dragon once seen in the sky, though no one can be sure if this is just a myth. Alright. Let's see. What weapons? Do we get a bow? I think it looked like we had a crossbow to start off with. Which, not sure how I feel about that. Yeah. Oh, we don't have a sword either. Lovely. Alright. Who's coming to get us? Where are you coming from? Oh, he's not even close to us. Oh, I can hear him. There he is. See if we can take out his legs. Nope, he's got some good shield skill. I hate spears so much. Tell you what. Can we get an overhead? No. Overhead, please. There we go. Let me pick your sword up if I can. Thank you. Alright, where's the merchant at? Why did it take so... Why are they spawning so far away? Oh, there you are. Hello, mate. Yes, I am alive. I'm doing just fine. Should we do the opening mission here? Yeah, you know what? Sure. It'll give us some money at least and something to do. We'll go ahead and do the opening mission. Yep. Alright. Okay, let's take a look at it. Here it is. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So here are the dwarves. This is our goal. Our goal is to eventually take these guys out. And so here's the Realm of the Falcon. This is what you guys want me to join. One thing I'm not so fond about them with is that all their troops, literally all their troops have blunt weapons, so they don't actually kill the enemies, they just knock them unconscious. And so that's great for making money, but it's not so great for when you're trying to, actually hurt an empire and, defeat a lord. So I don't know how I feel about that. We can probably just implement some of these troops with some of, other random troops, so it's not that big of a deal. But we'll figure it out as the time comes. Alright, so where are we? Murdenhall. High Dragon Priest. Awesome. Okay, oh, hello. Welcome to Perisno, adventurer. You will soon find that this mod is a bit harder than native, and brings you to an entire new world. You will meet new NPCs, discover long-lost treasures, embark on dangerous quests, and more. Currently the year is 365. You are just one of thousands of men out there who seek to change the future. The Kingdom of Talrania spreads across the center of Perisno. The Reich des Draken, with their strange creatures and heavy cavalry, dominate the north along with Macavia. The kingdoms of Drahara and Haken share the deserts, and the elven kingdom of Redwood inhabits the forests. Minor factions, like the Demon Worshippers and the Assassins of Raldon. Raldon? Not sure how you pronounce that. Lurk about. Waiting to catch easy prey, and in a land far away, a fleet of ships are preparing to sail for Perisno. In your travels, you will encounter rogues, merchants, heroes, and more. Awesome. Alright. So I guess let's go ahead and try to recruit a few guys. Hold up, let me check out the inventory. Alright, sweet, we do have a sword. Get rid of that lance. Tell you what, no, forget the crossbow. We'll keep the lance for right now. That could come in use if we encounter some pretty elite guys. We're never going to use that crossbow. All right, so let's get a few guys rolling here. Now, we're going to want to enter a tournament pretty soon here just to get some starting cash. Oh, sweet, 5 of them already. Nice. So let's actually check out what tournaments are going on immediately. Just so we have a general idea. You should put a shirt... Actually, I'm not going to lie. If I had a body like that, you might as well keep your shirt off. Yep, whatever. Tournaments. Fryzing, that's pretty close, I'm pretty sure. Amarna, Arish, Grozny, Crane, Bogan. I don't think I've heard it either, or any of those. Maybe Amarna sounds familiar. But Fryzing, I'm pretty sure that's just north a little bit, right? Right? Yeah, okay, okay. Then we have... Amarna, is that down here somewhere? Oh, Bogan? Was that on the list? I'm pretty sure Bogan was. That's kind of close, too. And Amarna's all the way down there. Okay, let's tell you what. Let's head north, I think. We'll go ahead and check out a few more villages. Make sure... Hello, who's this? Deserters? Oh, Draken Fusildat. I think I'm willing to fight you. I mean, should be okay. Just 6 troops? Are they on horseback, is the question. Ooh, okay. Are they on horseback? Ah, sweet, this lance can couch. Very nice. No, they are not. Okay. I think we should be okay. Tell these guys to charge in, even though they're probably not going to do shit. These guys ranged? No. What are they doing? Boom! Ha ha! Too easy. Alright, let's see how this sword is. Okay, blocked us. Not bad. 47 damage? Okay, it's not too shabby. Not too shabby. So, guys, something I have to talk about. I watched the Bannerlord. Didn't actually see the live stream itself, but I just watched the footage afterwards. I actually slept in too late. I woke up, it was like 1 o'clock, and I was like, shit. Of course, a bunch of you guys had already commented on the video, like, one of you is even like, hey, less uploading BMP, watch the damn stream. But, yeah, oh my god, Bannerlord, like, that gameplay trailer, it looks so gorgeous, guys. It seriously looks so nice. I'm so excited. It literally cannot come soon enough. Alright, leveling up already, that's what I'm talking about. Getting some better armor. You're damn right. Actually, not better armor. Never mind. You would presume, but I guess not. And some throwing spears, alright, sure. Whoa, that's actually worth some cash, though. I like it. I forgot about that in Perisno, though, that, cash is, like, not... doesn't go as far as you think it would, but as such, you kind of get a lot of it in return. Alright, some more power draw, even though we don't have a bow yet. Sure, why not? Let's get some more archery flowing. I love it. Alright, let's head over here. One of the things, so, I don't know, I'll probably just talk about random things I noticed through the gameplay trailer. One, I love how the map, the further you zoom in, one, the map is, like, huge. It's set in Calradia, but the old map covers just maybe a third of what this new map is. Like, the old map is a small portion of this new map, which is insane. Oh, no one wanted to join us, huh? That's rude. Okay, guess we'll head over here. Second of all, I love how in detail the map is, and the more you zoom in, the more detail you see. It's just so, so damn gorgeous. Bunch of Volhir Raiders. I don't think we're quite ready for them yet. Other guys we could handle. 34 Volhir Raiders. I'ma have to pass. Let's keep on going to Fryzing. Let's get to this tournament. Oh, God, what the hell? Snowcrawlers? Bunch of Volhir Raiders. Are we faster than them? Oh, just barely. Yeah, welcome to Perisno. Prophecy of Pendor might be harder in the long run, but Perisno, it pulls no punches at the start. You got everybody in here. Should go to the tavern, maybe? Never know, we'll see. You are a musician. He's wearing armor. He's wearing plated armor. Alright, sure, I'm not gonna judge. Hauptmann Konzil. Oh, you sell mercenaries. Okay. Ransom Broker, Sword Sister. Okay, pretty generic. Who are you? Tylan. You seem like a hero. Okay, never heard of you. Are you free? 8,000. You are not free. Okay, never mind. See you later. Okay. Oh, wait. Is this... Hold up. Was this in the last version? Landlords and moneylenders. That is awesome. Oh, sweet. That means, like, we can... Oh, that is so... That is what I wish was in Prophecy of Pendor. Oops. Okay. I thought we got attacked there for a second. I was like, son of a bitch. What do you have against me, Baron Willibald? Oh, Baron Willibald. Alright, let's fast forward a little bit. Morning. Okay. Almost there. Oop, who's this? Volunteer Raiders? Don't. Please don't. Yeah, don't attack me. I don't know. I don't want to deal with archers quite yet. Yep, get out of here. Can we start a tournament yet? Yes, we can. Alright. Make a cool 4,000 from this, hopefully. Four teams of five. So damn sunny. Ooh! First blood. Boom! Oh, that actually did too much damage at all. Felt like it would. It did not. Everyone has some pretty good armor in this. It's kind of like that chainmail looking stuff. Do we have any one-handed swords we could take? I don't really want to practice my two-handed right now. Horse out of the way. Wow. Literally not doing any damage to this horse, huh? Okay. Might be. Oops. Dang, this snow is really bright. It's like, it's kind of like what it looks like in Perisno right now. For whatever reason, when I turned up the graphics to make everything look nicer, the snow all of a sudden became really, really bright. And it is kind of realistic, but only like a certain kind of snow is actually this freaking bright. It only at like noon, like at when the sun's perfectly at its highest, highest point. Four teams of eight, really? Okay. Lovely. This sounds so dirty. Like, the Sword Sister is like, Seriously, the noises they make, I never realized they sound so bad. Oh, that's awful. Oop. Hello, Red. I'm not interested in fighting you today. Oh, yes, I just remembered. Perisno, so not only do they have the moneylenders and stuff, but their whole guild system and, you know, buying land and stuff, that's different too. A lot of things cost more money, but they give out way more. So instead of, like, a dyeworks being the most expensive thing you can buy, it costs, like, what, 10 grand for that, and you might get 500 to 600 a week from it. Now you have a bunch of stuff that are worth in, like, I don't know, like 1,500 to even some of them are worth, like, in the 2,000s, I want to say, per week. And they cost a little bit more, but not that much more. So that's very useful. And it's kind of necessary because the troops in this mod cost a ton. Like, more than Prophecy of Pendor. Even though they aren't as strong as the ones in Prophecy of Pendor, they still cost as much. Or cost more. We need to train up our archery. No? How did that not hit you? Headshot? Come on. There we go. 64 archery. We're going to have to work on that a lot. How did we miss that shot? Okay. Boom. What do we got left? Sword Sister? What round are we in? Fourth. Three teams of one? Okay. Okay. I ain't afraid. Good hit. Good hit. Bring back around. There goes one. I don't even know what you're doing. One. And... Nope, nope. Come on, there we go. Boom, down. Yep, Laughlin takes over after his father, for sure. But let me... Dang, he... Oh, we just start out with so many stats. Like, honestly, we have an... To start out with 8 Ironflesh? It's insane. Why am I throwing this? I probably shouldn't be. It's kind of working, I guess. How did that not... There we go. Alright, last round. Wow. One-shotted. Get wrecked. There we go. Alright. Let's go flirt with some ladies. There are ladies here, right? Okay, I see two. Two potential bachelorettes here. What do we got? Hi, in door one, we have Fra Mathilde. Okay, she's kind of cute. She's kind of cute. Oh, you are a wife to Baron Matthias. Awkward. Okay, ooh, Fra Ludwiga. Not sure about your name, but you're a dime. So, you are sister-in-law, and you're also wife. God damn it. Well, at least you're not his wife. So, we're just going to go ahead and dedicate these successes to you. Oh, wow. 8 relationship with her? She's just asking. She wants to cheat. I think we've established this so far. Well, we'll come back to this. We might come back to this. Oh, look. Oh, she's totally checking out our ass as we walked. Oh, my God. They both are. Sorry, Lord Matthias. I can't help it. These glutes are just amazing. It's what happens when you have 8 iron flesh. Buns of steel. Okay, let's sell this. Get the crossbow. Yeah, some pretty cool looking helmets. That one's pretty nice. 20,000. Oh, yes. I forgot how expensive everything was. Thick Perisno Twilight Boots. Those are pretty good. 42 leg armor. That is pretty good. 115,000 for that. 62. Oh my god. 62.28? Hello. Yeah, that is some beastly armor. Paladin armor. Oh, check us out with that. Oh my god, we're looking spiffy. 30 grand, huh? Not quite there yet, but someday. Someday we'll get there. Let's check out what do we got over here. Can't be used on mount. Forget about that. Well-made Perisno bow. That looks kind of not so well made. That looks like a regular hunting bow. Not too surprising. I don't think the Reich is not exactly known for its great bows. So, it does have some pretty good horses, though, from what I hear. However, we do have a courser with speed of 56. Holy shit. Forgot how fast some of these horses were. Heavy courser. What is that? Just our courser, except more charged hit points and armor? Not worth 18 grand, that's for sure. Alright, well. Oh, tell you what. Who was it? Was it Putless? Was it good old Poot that was telling me about a... Oh, fuck. Oh, there's only 5 of them. Okay. I'm not afraid of 5 bowmen. Charging, guys. Ooh, N for help. What do we got here? Whistle for horse, first aid, battle cry... Okay, alright. I'll look at that later. Yeah, these are just some weak bowmen. Time to get wrecked, sons. It didn't even try to swing at us. 113 damage, that's what I'm talking about. Ooh, ouch. Oh, what is this? Light wound? What do you mean I suffer a light wound? What is this? This is bullshit. They do have the morale system in place. But what was that they were talking about wounds and stuff? Making me nervous. Almost there. Nope, you ain't surviving this. Get wrecked. Have we leveled up again yet? Is that a thing? Oh, hello. Put that on. Finally got a helmet. Ah, there we go. Now we leveled up. Oh, we did level up before too. Okay. Boom, boom. And boom, boom. Jesus, are we gonna be... We're going to be at, like, maxed out strength in this first episode. What would that be, 6 more levels? I don't know. But I think it was Putless that was telling me about some quest in Reichburg. Let's go check that out. Gotta get a quest out of the way. That'd be nice. So, similar to Perisno, or similar to Prophecy of Pandor, there are a bunch of... Oh, Jesus, okay. Good thing those snowcrawlers didn't decide to just shit on us. they're running from Ilka Falky, though, which makes me nervous. Oh, yeah, 77 Ilka Falky would not be fun to fight. 6 of you are following me. Okay, I'll fight 6 of you. don't know why all these tiny armies are trying to pick on us. Especially when we outnumber them. It's one thing, like, when there's only a couple of us, or when I'm walking alone, I could feasibly see them thinking that they could take us on. Where's this dude at? Oh, there he is. Ooh, you got a tough horse there, huh? Help me, my men. Or I'll just do it all by myself. As I normally do. Ironflesh soaked 0 damage. What is this? What is this new battle system? I really don't know. Wonder if there are mod options for this. So if I remember right, Perisno has that stupid option where your horses get slow as shit as they get injured. And I hate that with a passion. So I'll probably turn that off. Why does it keep on asking me if I want to retreat? I don't know. Glory-seeking man. You sound like the type for us. Join us. This all looks like shit, but we could use the money. There we go. Alright, so let's head into Reichburg. Let's see what quest he was talking about. Is that the tavern? Veteran gladiator. I doubt it. Tavern shopper? Drinking game. There's nothing I'd like better than to spend my time drinking my hard-earned gold away, but I shall join you. Not sure. What happens? What are we... 10 coins. Another one. Oh, what? We've 8 iron flesh. How'd we lose that? Okay, at least we only lost 10 coins. I don't think who we're looking for is in here, though. Because I'm pretty sure this is a troop. Yeah, these are guys we can hire. Traveler, no. Huh. It's probably in the castle, then. Oh, I think this is who we're supposed to talk to. Damn. Can we dedicate tournaments to her? High Priestess, High Dragon Priestess, Kivakis? Who are you, fool? Why have you come to me without kneeling? Well, damn. I am Lothlin Sunbeam. My apologies, my lady. I am unaware of your customs. If I may ask, who are you? I am Kivakis, one of the 3 High Priestesses of the Dragon in the Reich des Draken. High Dragon Priestess Amara is my twin sister. Okay, we've seen her around a lot. My question still stands. Why have you come to me? I've come seeking adventure. Might you have a task for me? Okay, alright. I think this is what we're looking for. A task? Why, yes. I was just thinking about this earlier. I need a capable band of mercenaries to escort a group of my Wyvern Riders to Voldeburg. They are on a mission to deliver a letter to the Baron there, and they must reach their destination. Could you possibly lend a hand in this? Okay, I'm not sure if we're really a mercenary group, but sure, yeah. Why are you trusting me with such an important task already? And second, can't the Wyvern Riders defend themselves? That is a good point. I hear they are fearsome fighters along with their mounts. Oh, are these Dragon Riders? Why am I trusting you? You don't look like a spy or someone who is working with our enemies. And know that I can summon the wrath of the entire Reich and all of our dragons and dragon riders to destroy you. The Wyvern Riders can defend themselves well enough, but recently we've heard reports that our enemies, the sectarian dragon priests, are getting stronger. Okay, I see. Why do I get the feeling we're about to get attacked as soon as we step out of the town? What do we got here? Wyvern Riders? Okay, that's for us. You must be our escort, right? Yep. I will lead you to Voldeburg. Wow, he looks sunburned. Whoa! Okay, and right into the sectarian dragon priest. Alright, well, hello, traveler. What have you got with you? I don't know. What do we have with us? Who are you to ask that? Who am I? I'm a dragon priest, a true dragon priest. I see you have some of your wyvern friends with you. What I do is none of your business. Oh, talking shit. No need for rude words, fellow traveler. Better hand over your money and let us deal with the Wyvern Riders now. I will pass, thank you. Instead, I think you should hand me your money instead. Okay, Laughlin, look, hold on. You're a great fighter and all. You're also level 4 and massively outnumbered. Oh, sweet. At least they join in and help us. 67 against 62. Let's do this. Oh! Oh, look at these Wyvern Riders. Oh, that looks awesome. We're on like drakes. Oh, and here comes the enemies. Holy shit. Alright, let's, personally, let's get the hell out of here over here. Come in and try to get a good lance off. I don't know how strong our, the Wyvern Riders are compared to these dudes. Nope. Okay, we missed. Just kidding. We're making a run through. Testing the waters. It's looking good. Now we're coming in. Boom! Haha! It's 504 experience. These guys are pretty tough. They are pretty tough, let me tell you. Oh, damn it. That's close on him. Not gonna lie, don't normally use lances. Everyone in Perisno uses lances, though. It's a little annoying, actually. Where do I see one of these guys at? Maybe one of them that's kind of stationary. Here we go. Let's aim for this dude if we can. God, they're fast. We need some more riding skill. Boom! Aha, there we go. Another 504 experience. Leveling up again. I love it. God, we would have been so fucked if we didn't have the Wyvern Riders help us. Oh, this would have been bad. Luckily, we seem to be doing a pretty good job altogether. Jesus, we have a courser. How fast are these guys? It's got to just be that we have a lower riding skill. Oh, boom! 3 kills. Oh, God. Okay. It's a good thing they were all on our side. Those couch lances would have been painful. Is that victory? Yeah, there we go. All thanks to us. You guys would have never stood a chance if I wasn't there. Those three extra riders would have been crucial. Oh, and we only had one of our guys wounded. That's not even that bad. Oh, there's three of them left. Here's the real tough battle. Let's meet these guys head on. Probably not a smart idea. Where are they coming from? Oh, they're over here. Whoops. Okay. So much for head on. Here we go. Yeah! Boom! What? Who hit us? This dude hit us somehow? Overhead. Nice! And we killed him too! Oh yeah. There we go, Laughlin. Start spreading the legend. Let them know about you. Ooh. Ooh hoo hoo. Some very nice armor. Oh man, those are some really nice boots too. Awesome, awesome. Let's get a pretty nice shield as well. I guess we might as well have both the shields right now. Can't use these coursers yet. However, this lance, though, it's just about as fast, has more reach, and does same amount of damage? Can crush through blocks? Sure. Actually, no, we're not going to use lances that much. We'll just, might as well sell it and make some more money off of it. Boom. Holy shit. Level 7, 8, 9, and 10. Boom. Just like that. Hold up. What did I tell you guys? Maxed out strength on the first episode. First episode. Boom. Maxed out power strike. Maxed out iron flesh. Maxed out power draw. That's what I'm talking about. And now we can pump up our archery a decent amount. Keep it coming. 107. Alright, let's, I'm feeling confident now. Let's escort these guys. Keep on following me. 52 Wyvern Riders. That's pretty tanky, man. This guy's pretty good. Not gonna lie. Alright, Voldeberg, now that's where we're headed to. Ooh, Snowcrawlers, how you doing? I will fight you. I'm feeling confident now. Feeling good about myself. Actually, hold up. Now that I think about it. Snowcrawlers are actually pretty good, from what I remember. Yeah, because they have bows and shit. Okay, well, let's try to do what we can here. I'm imagining we're going to lose a few troops here. Okay, they're at least pretty easy to take out. They just can't get hit. We are not bulletproof right now. Oh, shit. Shield up again. Leveling up again. Level 11 already. First episode. This is a good start. Knock on wood. Hold up. I'm in the middle of a battle. Can't do it right now. Stays that way, though. Oh, hell yes. All the damage. Where is this guy? Oh, he's hiding. He's retreating. Now, you guys can charge in. Do damage, you know, what I'm paying you for. Not paying you a lot, not gonna lie. You're only getting an orm a week. Which, in Perisno, is like nothing. Down you go. GG. No re. Okay. I'm not even sure if I really want to spend money upgrading you guys. Maybe the recruit Destrakens? Yeah, we can spare 100. I think we want to go the Fusil Dot, right? Yeah, Fusil Dot, because the Bogan shoots our bows. Glory Seeking Man, volunteer or a village guard? Oh, they're all on foot now. Shit. Village guard? Sure. I don't know. I don't see why not. Arrows. Okay. Generic stuff. Ooh, we need to sell some stuff off, don't we? Okay. We are moving our way to Voldeburg, though. We're getting there. We'll go ahead and end the episode off once we get there, though. And turn in this quest. Actually, I don't know if we turn in the quest there. We might have to go back to the Dragon Priestess. Holy shit, they're fast. Okay. See you guys. See you. Faster, you know? Yes, okay. Oh, fuck, they're attacking our Wyvern Riders. Shit. I guess let's go in and help them. Man, this is a action-packed first episode, let me tell you. Ilka Falky are pretty strong, too. Okay, let's go, Wyvern Riders. Oh, my God. Okay, you guys are all going in first. I'm not. Fuck that. It's all on you guys. Good luck, GL. Boy, we had a bow. Okay, we seem to be doing pretty good so far. The Ilka Falky are really all about being really mobile cavalry, so kind of having them in this forest where they can't really move around is really good for us, since the Wyvern Riders are more tanky cavalry. That's what the Reich is about. Oh, damn it, nearly had them there. That would have been sweet. We already killed one, at least. We did our part. Let's get another kill just for shits and giggles. Oh, come on. We're close. There we go. Nope. Ooh, hello. Here are some of their archers. I don't like being in the open with these guys. Not at all. Should we take out a lance? Oh, he's retreating. Okay, it looks like a bunch of them are kind of retreating now. They're so much faster than us. It's not even funny. Oh, man. Okay, they're down. Let's see if we can get this guy. Nope. How many are left? 4? 5. What is our riding right now? Let's go ahead and up our agility here. Riding is, oh, 3 or 2. Okay, it's not the greatest. That kind of explains it. Okay, we'll up that to 3. Continue working on that. I'm going to want to start putting some points into riding, horse archery, and shield, I think, for the time being. I think that's where we kind of want stuff right now. Yeah. We don't have a bow yet, but we are looking to get one eventually. All right, there we go. Took out his horse. And how did we not? Okay, someone else stole our kill there. I can't complain too much. They're saving our lives. Wrecked him. I know. Alright, let's see if we can get a lance off here. I'm looking at you. Boom! Oh, Kafalki Ranger, get wrecked. Overhead. Boom! Another one down. Another one bites the dust. Yeah, we're doing some good damage already. Even though we have some shitty armor. Well, our boots are actually pretty good right now. Thank you for your help. No problem, man. We don't really want any of these guys, I don't think. I don't want to split the XP with them, at least. Which, should we get a decent amount of XP for that? Oh, we didn't. Never mind, we could have taken them. Okay. We're making our way to Voldeburg. Slowly, surely, plagued by battles, but we are getting there. Keep on following us, mates. More Ilka Falky, lovely. Jesus, I knew it was going to be rough, but I mean, come on. I thought it was just going to be having to take care of the dragon priests. Oh, come on. Help me out, man. They are no help whatsoever. If I just stay by Voldemort, will they eventually come? Is that a thing? Alright, we're almost there, regardless. Is this close enough for you guys? Boom. There we go. No, I do not want to fight them. No. You misunderstand. Alright, there we go, guys. Well, I think we're going to go ahead and end it off there. Before we do so, let's go ahead and sell some stuff off. Stuff that we're not going to be using. Makes a decent amount of cash right here, I think. Boom, boom, boom. Oh, yeah. Another 46 hundo. What does that take us up to? 13,569. Let's go ahead and... Let's talk to the guildmaster right quick and get our first piece of land if we can. I think I see him right there. Hello, chap. Okay. Whoops. No. Oh, Jesus. Damn it. Okay. Wish to buy land. Ew. You're not going to... Not gonna let me, huh? Why? People like me here. Well, they don't like me, but they don't hate me. Does the Lord not like me? Baron Herman? Baron Herman, where you at, man? Let me talk to you. That's Baron Rolf. Baron Herman, do you not like me? No, why don't they let me buy anything from them? Huh, I'm not sure. Whatever, we can figure that out next episode. So, guys, leave some comments down below. Let me know what you think about this series and all the rest of the series that we got going on right now. I'm excited. I think we're going to have some fun with this. We're already off to a great start. We're level 11 after the first episode? Maxed out strength already? Maxed out Ironflesh, Power Strike, Power Draw? That's what I'm talking about. That's pretty good. It's a good start. But, as always, guys, take it easy.